I would now like to invite Director for Academic Relationship, PMI Bangalore India Chapter, Lieutenant Colonel Shri Harsha for the vote of thanks. Colonel Shri Harsha brings with him 28 years of rich experience and brings with him a wealth of experience in the areas of strategic planning, construction management, financial management, human resource management, and crisis and risk management. As a project management consultant, he handles projects of various industry sectors. He is a consultant with Jacobs Engineering and manages multiple projects across the country. He has executed projects of diverse nature in challenging environment across the length and breadth of the country, including the cold region of Antarctica and in the African continent. His papers on various facets of project management and team management have been published in technical journals, and he has also presented papers on at national seminars and conferences on the subject. He is an excellent speaker, a prolific trainer, and apart from a BE degree in civil and MBA, he holds a PG diploma in human rights law and master's degree in business law from the prestigious National School of India University. By the way, Colonel is a very ardent learner. And in case if you're thinking that he has completed all these degrees when he was young, no. In fact, the master's degree in the business law, he just completed it last year. So there is no age for learning, and keep learning. Continue learning is going to be a continuous process in your life, is what the other message that I also wanted to convey. So please put your hands together and welcome Colonel Shri Harsha.
Good evening, boys and girls and faculties of the colleges. It was indeed a pleasure to have you with us throughout the day. Till last year, we were conducting a half-day session where we would just give some brief introduction into the project management concepts. This year, we experimented with a new concept. We brought in a small essay competition to get the students thinking on these lines, and also some people from the industry to address you and tell you that when you have a dream, dream big, and it can be achieved. Today we had with us in the afternoon session three people who had achieved their dreams, and I'm sure it would be a learning for all of you to take back home. Before I conclude, I would just like to draw your attention to what the inaugural speaker had spoken, that by about 2020 and 2022, there is a big market to be reaped. And including the valedictory speaker, it was highlighted that project management today has become a very fundamental and essential skill. It's no longer that which you could have, it is something which you must have. If you do not take this opportunity to imbibe these skills into yourself, when the job market opens up, we would have somebody else taking that away from our plate right in front of our eyes. Today, US is facing a similar problem where they are thinking of bringing embargoes on employment of outsiders. There was a time when they brought in people from all different nations into the US, the economy grew, and the local people were left outside the job market. Basically because they did not have the required skills, the required competencies. Today, we are at that threshold where we may face a similar situation, and that was what the inaugural speaker highlighted to us. So I would like to urge you all to see how best you can tread this path of project management. We have just shown you a small glimpse of what exactly is there in store for you. We haven't shown you the full story. Continuous learning process, project management is a never-ending story. What you learn today will not be applicable tomorrow. Murphy's Law is there to hit you. Parkinson's is there. It's something different, something challenge. As you see in the very definition of project, it is something unique. So every project being unique, the challenges are different. How you apply these principles are all going to be different. But one thing is, at least if you are prepared, you'll be able to take on these challenges. Today we see that the lamp is still burning. Apart from the light that it sheds to push away darkness and all that, there's a teaching which tells us what? It is how you prepare the lamp, the wick, and how it is lit that ensures that the lamp burns for a very long time. I'm sure all of you have tried lighting a lamp at home, right? If you just put the wick into oil and tried lighting, you'll spend your complete matchbox just trying to light that wick and it won't catch a fire. There's a way of preparing the wick. Rub it. The harder you rub, the better it is prepared and the longer it will burn. So there is no pleasure without pain. Please be prepared to take the pain. Like how our young friends told, this is the age for you to take it. After you become 40, 50, he was referring to people like us. We can't afford to take the risk which you people can afford to take today. Be prepared to go out, face the world. Take risks. Thereafter, you can sit back and enjoy. Reap the fruits, enjoy. Feel contented that you have done something to the society. With these few words, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all the colleges for having nominated the students. Again, you are a privileged lot. You are in that 30% as per current statistics who had the privilege of coming to higher educations. So I should be grateful to your parents and your colleges who are given an opportunity to learn. I'm thankful to the colleges for having nominated the students, having come here to spend the whole day with us. I also would like to place on record the appreciation to DAAD and IPL for having come here just to give you a glimpse of what is in store as a career for you people as you step out into the professional world. Last but not the least, I'd just like to draw your attention to the way PMI functions. PMI is a volunteer body. Volunteers are professionals who are students, sometime like you, who had a passion, who work elsewhere and come here to share their experiences, spend time here to conduct events. So there's a team of volunteers who have put up this event, full day event for all of you, including evaluating your essays, people who have worked offline in the night to evaluate your essays. So the whole lot of effort which has gone in. I'd like to thank all the volunteers for having put up this event together. Thank you all.
What begins well, ends well. And ladies and gentlemen, now I invite all the students, the faculty members, the session speakers here for a photograph, a group photo.